Hey guys, Justin here, and today we're going to cover TE-Smart's 8 and 16 port single monitor KVM switches. We see these most commonly used to manage several computers, servers, gaming consoles, or surveillance systems. Let's run through the physical features really quick and then dive into some cool demos. All right, on the front of the device here, we have these three round buttons, which are used to adjust the auto scanning time interval. It can be set from 6 seconds all the way up to 60 minutes. When you press the buttons here, you can see the LCD will read out the amount of time. You press set, and then when you turn the scan function on, you can see the blue light under status here lights up, and then it'll turn back off. These buttons right here are used to select the inputs, so you just press the number that you want to go to. And this button right here, close, is actually going to lock the front panel. So we press close, and you see dash dash, and now none of these inputs will have any impact. We can press close again to turn that off. On the 16-port model over here, you can see one extra row, and that's used to get through inputs 11 through 16. So if we want to go to 16, we press 1 plus, and then the number 6. On the right over here, we have the on-off switch, and this LAN port right here is actually used to connect this to your local network. Later in the video, we're going to pair one of these with a Pi KVM, so you can use your inputs from anywhere in the world. It's super cool. Big shout out to the Pi KVM community. All right, let's move on to the side here. Now here we have these four holes, which can be used to attach the included rack ears. This can be mounted in a standard 19-inch 1U rack space. These other holes over here are used for cooling. There's no fan, so it's all passive cooling, and these are completely silent. All right, flip over to the back. Now here we have our standard KVM inputs with HDMI and USB. And over here we have the HDMI output. The only difference between each model is the HDMI version. The A30 and A10 models are built for HDMI 1.4 for 1080p displays. The A1U models are built with HDMI 2.0 for 4K 60 displays. So if you have something in between, like a 1440p or a high refresh rate monitor, we recommend going with the A1U model. These two ports over here are for your mice and keyboards. They have emulation, so they only work with mice and keyboards and allow you to perform hotkey and mouse gesture switching, which we'll demo in a little bit here. These two additional USB 2.0 ports can be used for stuff like a webcam, speakers, or jump drive. If you need to add more USB ports, we highly recommend using a powered USB hub. You'll need that extra juice to power up your devices. The KVM's input is 12 volt, 2 amp, and each unit comes with its little infrared extender here, which can be plugged into this IR in. And this green 3-pin connector right here, this is called a Phoenix connector, and it's used to receive serial commands over an RS-232 connection. Comes with a little adapter right here. We're going to demo that a little bit later in the video. It's kind of an advanced feature, and it's pretty cool. All right, now let's go ahead and dive right into some use case demos for the KVMs and show them in action. We'll start simple, and we'll get more complex through the video. We'll be right back with the mixed media setup.